Today we're going to learn how to drill, tap, and ream. Let's talk about it. Today we'll be drilling 5 holes. The first hole will be a 1/2-inch through hole. The second will be a 1/2-inch reamed hole that will first be drilled with a 31/64 drill bit. Then a 3/4-inch deep hole that will be tapped for a 1/2-inch 13-threaded bolt. This hole will first be drilled with a 27/64 bit. This info was found on the tap reference chart. Then we'll drill a 1/2-inch through hole that will then be counterbored to the depth of a 1/2 inch. Lastly, we will drill a 3/8-inch through hole, then add a 82-degree countersink. We will first center drill each hole. This acts as a pilot and prevents the larger drill bits from wobbling slash walking on the top of the surface. We have additionally programmed the position of each of these holes, the top left being the origin. Now we're going to be drilling our 1/2-inch through hole. And you guessed it, we're going to be using our 1/2-inch drill bit. We're going to be running the mill in low range at the specified RPM given by the machinist. We're going to be using plenty of cutting oil for lubrication and coolant. Now we'll be doing our reamed 1/2-inch through hole. We cannot directly use a 1/2-inch drill bit, so we will instead use a 1/64 smaller. That will allow us to use a reamer to bring it to the exact size. So with our 31/64 drill bit in the chuck, we can now begin to drill in low range using plenty of cutting oil. We now have the 1/2-inch reamer in the chuck. Note that when using the reamer, we need to apply constant pressure and will not be backing out at all while still using plenty of cutting oil. We have the RPM set to the specified value given by the machinist. Note on the forward hole, the scratch marks are consistent, and on the reamed hole at the back, everything looks shiny, aka more accurate. Next, we are going to drill and tap our hole. We have already set the desired depth and have moved up the knee 3/4 inch. Using a tap chart, we have found that for a 1/2-inch 13-threaded hole, we're going to use 27/64 drill bit through aluminum. We have our drill bit set up, and we will still use cutting oil. Now we have the hole drilled, we can begin to tap. We will first use the gun tap, which is the gold one. Notice it has a more aggressive taper, which allows for ease of starting threads. We will then re-tap with the bottoming tap, which allows threads to reach the bottom of the hole. With the tap center in the chuck, we can now put the top of the tap center in the top of the tap and the tap in the hole. Be sure that the tap center has constant pressure on the tap to line everything up. And after applying cutting oil, we use both hands to begin the tapping process, and after a few turns, you can then back off to cut chips. Once Once we think we're getting to the end, we want to apply constant pressure. Not a lot of pressure, but pulling up with both hands, because we don't want to cut the first thread twice. There we go. So our first tapping job is done. Now we will tap with a bottoming tap. We'll put it in just as before. Top of the tap center and the top of the tap. And tap in the hole. Apply cutting oil. And screw in a few more turns and still just back out to cut any chips. There we go. Hole is now tapped. Might need a slight cleaning. We'll see if our bolt fits. Seems to be tapped well. Now we're gonna finish our counterboard half inch hole. So we've already drilled our half inch through hole and zeroed the Z axis on the bottom of the bore and raised the knee 500 thousandths. This counterbore bit has a bottom guide pin that ensures proper alignment. We're gonna use cutting oil, and now we can begin to drill the counterbore in low range. Now with the counterbore finished, you can see this bolt drops in here perfectly. Now we're gonna finish our 3/8 through hole with the 82 degree countersink. We have the through hole finished. The countersink bit in the chuck. The best process to do this is to go down a certain depth, check it with the bolt, and then iterate. We wanna use cutting oil. Turn the vise on. And this should be fine and within tolerance.